going to first make sure that the student is firmly attached to the ground. I call this Sphinx position. So hands are really attached to the ground, shoulders are rolled back, the neck is long. You're going to have the feet apart and flat on the ground and not turned out. So you're completely parallel. The hip bones right under here, you're going to press the hip bones into the ground so that we are not necessarily tugging the tailbone, but lengthening the back of the spine. You're going to take the feet and the arches and press the arches into the ground so that we are lifting the knees up off of the ground. Now this sometimes students really have a difficult time with. You want to make sure that they are not gripping in their quads as they're doing this, but rather they're just lifting the knees up off of the ground. So now the lengthening comes into play when we have the toes fully lengthened so we're not sickled back here. We're nice and long. Students who might have issues sickling their feet, I would encourage you to put the feet together so that they can feel the flatness of the foot next to each other, and then once they get that, then they can move it up into this position. And so what I have them do is we press the knees up off of the ground, and we're going to reach the toe as far away from the body as we can, and then set the toe back down. You notice my knee is still up off of the ground. Then the other foot, lengthen the toe up off of the ground, and set the toe back on the ground. Then I'm going to lengthen the whole leg up and off of the ground, and I'm growing the leg longer. I am not lifting. I'm not trying to get the leg high. It's not about the height. It's about the length. And then setting the leg back down. And then the other leg is growing long and coming back on the ground. Then we are going to extend long, rotate the leg, bring it back in and set down. Extend the other leg long, rotate, bring it back in and set down. Now, you will see very little movement in the rotation for most students. Particularly because in this position, it's very hard to isolate the deep lateral rotators and the perfumus. So you have to really, really think about the length of the leg and turning from the hip knob and spiraling. And so once they're able to achieve that and they're not locking into their quadriceps, then I would encourage the student to lift both legs off of the ground, really reaching towards the back wall, spiral both legs, come back into parallel, and set the legs down. To do this in a seated position, you do not want to lift high, otherwise the students will bend the knee and lock into the quadricep. And I would encourage you to have the hands firmly attached to the ground and the shoulders rolled back. You can also have them turn out and reach so that they really feel the inner thighs. I really like this exercise for teaching jumps. I have them do an exercise that Eileen Nurek uses in her method, the power dance technique, and she has them press their feet against the wall and then jump and slide away from the wall. She calls it domino. It's a lot of fun and the kids love it, including the teenagers. But if you're in this position, either with the hands on the ground or with the hands on hips, and you have your students lengthen the legs off of the ground, really, really reaching, spiral the legs, and then really focus on the inner thighs coming to the top, turning the knobs, reaching the legs as long as you possibly can, they're going to have a lot more range of motion. I'm not locking into my quadriceps right now. They are engaged because anatomically there's no way for you to straighten your knee without your quads working. That's your quad's job. Your rectus femoris starts here, ends here. Its job is to straighten the knee. But there's a big difference between engaging the muscle and lengthening it and gripping and locking into it. So they need to feel this lightning bolt, the sunshine starting here and shooting out of their toes, the spiraling and lengthening. If they can find that, they're going to be able to do their tendus, their degages, everything with a fully lengthened leg rather than gripping into the leg and having the knee not fully lengthened. You're just gripping the quadricep. This happens a lot when you have students whose training is rushed. Students who are being asked to lift their legs higher than they are physically capable or ready to lift them. So if you have somebody who is trying to get a student to develop the leg and hold it, if a student's not strong enough, they're gonna end up gripping into the quadricep. So for students who are struggling to lengthen their legs, I put them against a wall. and have them touch the tip of their toes to the wall, like this. You're still in the same position, but the tip of the toes are touching the wall or the baseboard. Then I'm going to have them scoot just a tiny bit away, like literally not even an inch, and reach the legs towards the wall and try to touch the wall with their toes. Again, they are trying to physically touch their toes to the wall. They may or may not be able to actually lengthen their legs that far. Then you're going to scoot them a little bit farther away and continue to make them feel and lengthen towards the wall. This gives them something tangible to reach for. Rather than just lengthen your leg, you actually have something specific that you're trying to touch.
So how does this exercise pertain to plié tendu, dégagé, grimpement, développé? What I find is that when a lot of students are bending a standing leg when they do a grimpement or doing a développé and softening their leg, all of these things are connected to not lengthening in the proper directions. So if I have a student who is doing a développé and their standing leg is softening, that tells me a couple things. Number one, they're locking into their hip flexors, which is a big no-no. Number two, their pelvis is tilting, which is forcing the hyperextension and bending their knee, because it's activating the hamstring, and that's the hamstring's job, is to bend the knee. And number three, they are not lengthening either leg the direction that they should be lengthening. So the working leg should be developing and shooting lightning bolts out forward. The standing leg should be reaching through the heel down into the ground. I always tell my kids that you should be reaching the heel down towards China, and that is going to keep them up and out of their hip flexors, because they're focusing on the down and the up and the spiral and the lengthening of the standing leg. For grimpement, I find that if they're bending or manipulating their working leg too much, it's because, again, they're not pushing down through the heel of the standing leg. Also, to the back, what happens a lot is they close and slam the leg in and the leg bends. Again, it's a lengthening problem. And so from the bottom up, they should be lengthening up through the quadricep, but pressing down through the heel of the standing leg. And the foot should stop in fifth, wherever their fifth is. Their fifth may not be here. Their fifth may not be here. This might be your student's fifth to the back, based on their hip structure and their bone structure and their rotation. Please do not force your student into a position that is not good for their body. Related to tendus to the side, specifically, if the student is focused on hitting a position and getting to a position, their focus is already in the wrong spot. So if you're doing a tendu to the side, the focus should be initiate the movement with rotation, press into the floor, and grow the lift long, rather than hit a position. Because if you're thinking about hitting a position, you'll be not thinking about the process of getting there. And dance isn't about the end position, dance is about the process of getting there. So working through the leg, lengthening into the floor, articulating, and finding their rotation and their second position, and not focusing on actually straightening the leg. Sometimes if the student focuses too much on straightening the leg, it's going to force them to lock their quadriceps. If they're focusing on growing the leg as long as they can and making a longer tendu, then they're not going to be locking into their quads. My rectus femoris is engaged, but it's not locked in right now because I'm reaching through the entire leg and lengthening the muscles within gripping. And then, of course, pulling back in again, it's very important that they are not pressing and using their quadriceps to straighten their leg here. They should be using their rotation and their inner thighs to close the leg in tendu. You should not ever have a crunch and a squish, which I find happens a lot when you have a faster combination or, again, students whose technique and training has been rushed too quickly. So what I would recommend doing for students who are having issues straightening their legs would be to slow everything down and focus on the length. Focus on the articulation. When you hit that point where you can no longer, where your heel is attached to the ground and you're not able to just bring it in here anymore, focus on the slicing and the rotation of the inner thigh and really make them feel the inner thighs up through here. And the rotation and the spiraling and all that beautiful sort of movement. Squishes.